Hello everyone, today we are going to have a look at some of the most cancerous, autistic, fucking dumb as fuck reviews on my LittleBigPlanet levels, because I don't know, I wanted to put out a video or something. And yes, I know, I said the word autistic, but I'm autistic myself, but these guys bring autistic to a whole new level. I mean, they are autistic, like really. No, I mean, I just have Asperger's, but these people, like, just get a load of this. Okay, so, hang on. Crappy giveaway has a censored DLC, and you call it a giveaway. Like, what? Apart from just how dumb this review is, he came to my level. He saw that I used DLC and that he couldn't get the items, and he thought that my level was shit because of that. The whole point of LittleBigPlanet is that you can make what you want. And yeah, I wanted to avoid using DLC, but all the items I needed were DLC, so I had to use them. And yes, I call it a giveaway because it's a giveaway to people that have the DLC. I'm sorry that you're so poor that you can't afford the DLC. Oh, and let's just have a look at some of his levels. And yes, I played these earlier, you know, so you don't have to. Oh, and I loved I can't scroll around as Earth. Ha. Huh. Impossible. come on. Okay. Fight Training Academia 2. Two bosses. Fight. Big badass boss. Dead world. Ooh. trust me, if you want to see what's in these levels, go ahead. This guy's Umfi 2013, probably when he was born by the intelligence of his comments, but just get a load of his levels if you want a good laugh. if I can scroll around. Like, a lot of these are just copies of each other. Anyway, right, let's have a look at some of my other reviews. Let's see what else people have been saying. Oh yeah, this one got some good ones. Basically, okay, so for some context, you can play this level, but just to shorten it for the video. Basically, I made a level called How to Get Free DLC, where basically I told them that they can just go to the store and download the free DLCs. You know, as a joke and a troll and a meme. And my god, there were some stupid reviews. Like, apart from all the, oh yeah, thanks, you gave me the DLC, like, troll reviews. I got some really dumb as hell reviews. Human, these items were free in the first place. All you're doing is showing how to download a glitch that isn't a glitch. No way! I didn't know that I was telling people to download a glitch that isn't a glitch, that was just free on the store. I wouldn't have known. I should just delete this level right now. Let's see what's on this guy's Earth then. One level. Super Meat Oddsoid. It's one of those people that calls their levels like beta tests and puts like version 2.69 or something in the description. he's one of those kind of people. yeah. I already knew this, but I don't have the prehistoric pack, so thanks for saying it's free. Well, happy to help, mate. Thanks for, you know, thanks for coming to my level and, you know, learning something new. I think at least some good come out of this, apart from being just a massive troll level. Everyone knows that, and I thought you meant paid. Yes, that was the joke! I know, right? I'm such a funny edgelord. Seriously, these people have no sense of humour. The whole joke was that people were going to mistake it for paid DLC, and then they'd find out that when they played the level that it just downloads the free DLC. Like, that's all wink. I have all free stuff. Yeah, see, this guy thumbs up, but it's pretty obvious. Yes, indeed. These people are just so retarded. What, like, oh, copied levels. I see. Ah, that explains it. He's retarded. Everybody knows this method, but not everybody uses his crap grammar. I don't know. Let's see what levels he has. Is this a glitch where I can't scroll through people's planets that was introduced in the new update or something? I don't know why this is. Stupid. Honestly, I don't even know why these people claim my levels. Like, oh look, a copied level. How original. Like, usually I'd be saying something clever or witty, but you know, it just starts to get me down. Oh yeah, I got some of my best levels, my best reviews on my crown level, but it's gone because they actually banned it. And I might even show in a video because that was freaking hilarious. I made it with Reese and we had a hilarious time just watching all the plays roll in and reviews coming in. It was just hilarious. But too bad it's gone. I might have screenshots of the reviews or something, but it's gone. So yeah. So this is my other fake crown level, which I turned into a sub level for the other one. Oh yeah, this one didn't get any of the reviews. How to get the rarest costumes. Basically, I said, be original, make your own costumes, and stop trying to be one of the elite when you don't deserve the rare stuff. And let's just see what people say. Boo. Boo. Brr. I can't find the boo button. Well, you could have put the ghost costume or something, or the Emerald Jester, but no! No, you just gave us nothing other than some advice, some enlightenment to make our own costumes and be unique. Like, seriously, these levels already exist. You can already find the Emerald Jester or the ghost costume if you search Emerald Jester or ghost costume. Just search it and you will find it. But that's not what I promised. I promised the rarest costumes, and I gave them to you, but no. So I'm honestly interested to see... Oh. Memes. Yes. Gives no information. Well, this one puzzles me, because that's all the level really was, just loads of notes with information, but... You know, let's see. Oh yeah, I think I might have got some good games on. No, that's just my friend Troll. Let's see. I know, my levels are kind of crap, to be honest, but... Just the dumbass reviews, you know, give me hope. Let's see what... I don't like this level. That's because it's not a level, it's an adventure map. Yes, well, thank you for that legitimate criticism. I needed some feedback, I wasn't sure if my level was very good or not, you know? Oh yes, okay, these are the best reviews. I kind of showed them in my other video, but these have some really good ones. Okay, so Sao Gerdai. Now, she is actually referring to, if I can find him, Sao Gerdai 9, who says, by God, finally, I'm making more MNAF level just for that! Fuck you! I know, right? These people, they get so defensive over Five Nights at Freddy's. Like, I've got to do a live stream where I show off these levels, you know, just for context, in case anyone can't be asked to play them. But, like, these people think I'm just talking about Five Nights at Freddy's in the game. I can swear these people are actually illiterate. Like, they honestly miss the point completely. I hope the Undertale fan doesn't become like the FF fan. Oh, yeah, well, if this is a really old comment, or he is completely oblivious. Yeah, I'm sorry, but it already has. And this is from, like, by the way, I love Undertale. I mean, I'm not part of the fandom, to be honest. I avoid it like the plague. But I love Undertale. And it has become the new FNAF, you know? I'm enjoying FNAF games, so I'm working on jump scare stickers, but I plan to add detail to the level, not those crappy stickers, the ones you can import through SHAREfactory. Whoa, this guy is elite. He must have got the crown through a contest or something. Nah, I mean, if you enjoy the Five Nights at Freddy's games, that's fine. You do goo. But just stop making the levels. You completely missed the point of the level. Like, and importing SHAREfactory stickers, that's even worse, because that's just using a glitch to just basically rip photos from the internet. There's a paint tool, you could at least try your hand at that, at least try and make something creative. Five Nights at Freddy's is good, and you know it. Stop playing Five Nights at Freddy's if you don't like it. I think I did my other video on this review, but this is just dumb as fuck. I don't play Five Nights at Freddy's. I never played the games. And if you actually bothered to read, now if you actually bothered to go to primary school to learn to read, and then you actually played the level and read it, you would know that I don't play Five Nights at Freddy's, and I'm pissed off at the Five Nights at Freddy's community infesting this game. Dumb, censored. Well, thank you for that criticism of my level. You're scared of Five Nights at Freddy's, lol. Yes, that's exactly what I was trying to say in my level. Ignore what he said. Make 100,000 more Five Nights at Freddy's levels. Yeah, because reasons. That is the ultimate solution to this game. LittleBigPlanet. It's the deviant art of gaming, you know? It's just... It is. It is the deviant art of gaming. I mean, it's got its good stuff, but it's got its fucking cancer. Fuck you. Well, thanks for that. Very informative. I will definitely use that criticism in my next level. And then there's my review compilation. And then Rabbit Bloody, who did that last review, he actually said, "I'm sorry." But, yeah, and then there's, I don't think there's any cancer reviews on this. To be honest, this level is cringe. What? Do you mean as in their reviews that I put in the level, or my responses to reviews? I mean, I can agree that some of my responses were a bit cringe, but, I don't know. Scott made Five Nights at Freddy's because people hated Chiper and Friends, so delete this level. I'm conflicted. He told me to delete this level, but he yayed it. So, does that mean he likes it or hates it? I need to know the answer, because this one person wants me to delete the level, and obviously when one person tells me to delete a level, I must obey, you know? I must do what that one person says on my level of 244 plays. I just absolutely must, you know? Alright, so the scrolling glitch is happening on the level. Oh yeah, these are my old Locked LittleBigPlanet 2 levels, and they were pretty cringe, to be honest. Alright, just move your stupid cursor! But yeah, Were there any other cringe reviews? I don't seem to remember if there were. Okay, so, funny story. I made this level pretending that I was doing the SpongeBob DLC for free, and just look at these stupid reviews. Not rated for people with epilepsy. You do know that the PS4 keyboard has text suggestions, right? He used the PS4 on-screen keyboard, and he types that. How do spelling errors exist on PS4? Like, are these people illiterate? Honestly. Thank God I don't receive community photos. Yeah, I kind of warned you about it in my comment. Yeah, don't say I didn't warn you if you lose the stickers. hate it. Well, yeah, that's kind of the point. It's a troll level, you see. Really, bruh? Yeah, bruh. Yeah. Totes. Wow, a scam. I'm pretty sure something happened between these guys. Either they're the same person or they were playing two player, but their reviews are exactly the same. Like, I don't know why to put that. Unhearted. Oh no, I lost a heart. I lost one of my 267 hearts. Woe is me. I'll never recover from this. yeah, thanks, please. They're good, but it would be great if you had cameras so I could see the full body at once. It's asking for a lot, maybe, but I had some scenery or something. I hate the default ground. Well, yeah, fair enough. I didn't put much effort into the backgrounds and stuff, but I just figured it didn't need that stuff. I mean, I could have put a white sticker panel, but couldn't be asked. Also, about the camera, I actually had a zoom out camera in the level, and I'm pretty sure I put a note in saying that if you press triangle, you can zoom out, and I don't really get what he's on about. God damn it. I'm pretty sure. Oh great, there goes the phone. 1 second, I'll be right back. Okay, so I just had to take a phone call just then, but anyway, there weren't really any more cringe reviews. So let's get into these troll levels, because I bet you want some context behind these reviews. And I just might as well add them now, because I could do a live stream at a later date, but then, I probably, like, won't be asked to do it. Okay, so this is the rare costumes level. I have a secret to getting the rarest costumes in LittleBigPlanet 3 with a very simple method. The method is to make your own unique costume. What, did you expect a crown or a launch t-shirt? Those aren't rare at all, many people have them. Anyway, if you were to cheat to unlock those items, they would lose all value. If you make your own unique costumes, you will be the only person to have them, making them the rarest costumes in LittleBigPlanet 3. I understand that you may feel annoyed because you don't have the rare costume pieces, but if you really want them, you must earn them. And yeah, that caused everyone to spaz out because, oh my god, he like totally lied in the title, except not really, because you missed the point. Oh wow, look, a glitch. Then there was this one, Five Nights at Freddy's Mortal Kombat Minecraft Bomb Survival H4H Free Crown. Now, I made this quite a while back. It wasn't my cleverest troll level. I was just kind of pissed at everyone for making all of these unoriginal shit levels and like if you put this stuff in the tile, you get loads of plays instantly. Oh yeah, fun fact, I made these in LittleBigPlanet 2 back when I was a Minecraft baz. I mean, I still am a Minecraft baz, like I still play like battle mode and stuff. But yeah, I'm not as big of a Minecraft baz as I was then. So yeah, there's the Five Nights at Freddy's, yeah, the old Freddy's. There's your Minecraft content, on survival. And then there's the crown costume, and there's the waiting timer. Get the free crown. There's the level link. Yeah. I mean, it's not like I lied or anything, so, yeah. Let's see what else there is. How to get free DLC. Yeah, this is one of my more clever troll levels. I just said to myself. Hello. Today, I will show you how to unlock free DLC with one simple method. To download free DLC, go to the store and find DLC labeled free. Add it to your cart and download it. Congratulations, you have now got free DLC. This method only works on some DLC, such as the prehistoric pack. It doesn't work on any paid DLC. See? Like, this caused all the retards in the fucking review section to spaz out because they have no sense of humour. Let's see, where are some, let's see. So this is one of my levels. Basically, this is what I say. Important. I don't hate Five Nights at Freddy's fans. I do hate Five Nights at Freddy's fan cards. Regular fans who enjoy the game and don't spam levels to get salty are okay. Yeah, that was a little disclaimer. I think I put it in after I got loads of these shit reviews. No one was spazzing out. So yeah. Every dumb review goes in the cringe compilation. You can try to disagree and express your points, but getting salty will only bad. And yeah, I put this after a few of the cringe reviews, but I still got the cringe reviews anyway. Like, seriously. Completely changes my opinion in the presence of the Five Nights at Freddy's fan community. Okay. Wow, Five Nights at Freddy's fan cards get salty. If you had an argument, I would consider it, but you just get mad and defensive. Everyone is entitled to their opinions, but you're stuck. Update. I have counted 23, so Five Nights at Freddy's in the new Amazon business page, in just a few minutes of searching. Five Nights at Freddy's is fake. Please stop making FNAF levels and talking, and stop playing it. They suck and you know it. Every time I dive in, there's always Five Nights at Freddy's fan cards. The FNAF sewage levels are clogging up the new levels page, therefore preventing good levels, including mine. Okay, I was being a bit of a narcissist there, but it's true. They do prevent good levels from being seen. If you think my levels are good, then I suppose, yeah, my levels also part that. So it's all come from bingo. I also hate the Five Nights at Freddy's games too, but that's a road. Too much in LittleBigPlanet 3, and I need a break. I understand, you're a passionate community who hasn't played good games with good gameplay and story. You have Five Nights at Freddy's because famous YouTubers hopped on the bandwagon. Okay, I was being a bit of a dick there, but what's the bet that statement's true? Like, let's be honest here. A lot of Five Nights at Freddy's players are filthy casuals. Hey, I'm just being honest here. They barely play anything else other than what's popular. I mean, to be honest, I am a bit of a casual. I mean, looking at my game collection now, yeah. I mean, I'm not the most casual kind of. Actually, you know what? No, playing popular games doesn't make you a casual, but it just means you're unwilling to expand your horizon. And basically, I made this level because there were way too many Five Nights at Freddy's levels in LittleBigPlanet. Like, it was becoming a problem. If there was just a few, I wouldn't have complained, but it has become a massive problem, therefore warranting me making this level. Anyway, now is the time to solve. Please, be original, please. Thanks for playing, and don't get mad in the comments because that won't change my opinion. Oh yeah, and I put that as soon as I published the level, so they had no excuse to put in those reviews. Okay, so this is the review cringe compilation level I made. Now, yeah, funny story. Basically, PS4 screenshots, which were my only way of getting these, take up like a quarter of the thermometer. So I actually had to spread out the images and use the dynamic thermo just so I can get them all in the level. But I put in point trails to lead them between the areas. Why? I'm pretty sure some of these got deleted or something. I don't really remember. But yeah. I mean, of course, FNAF the game is better than my levels. I mean, my levels are pretty cringe, to be honest. But, I mean, you know, if one guy makes the whole game, that is commendable. I'm not afraid to admit that. I might hate Five Nights at Freddy's with every fibre of my being, but I'll admit, if pretty good game, considering they was only made by one guy. Gravy's gonna try because his levels suck. My levels do suck, I'll admit that. They're kind of cringe, I mean, compared to the shit that I've seen from these reviewers, though. They are freaking godlike, but these people completely missed the point of my levels. FNAF levels are okay. Yes, they're okay. That's why I had to make the level about the plague of them everywhere. Ignorant exploited. Like, yes, perfect. That will really improve the game, won't it? Yeah, look at this nice chap here. Like, he is, like, you know, it's the kind of guy you just meet on the street and you just want to hug him right there. I mean, to be honest, what other thing could it be? What other five-letter words could be censored? And LittleBigPlanet censors everything. Like, you can't say happened or computer without it getting censored. Yeah, I know. The word computer is just edgy as hell. Maybe because all these people saying PC Master Race, you know, it's become a bit of a slur to say computer, and it's become racist. Why do these people even bother to swear in the review? They know it censors it, so why do they do it? Funny story, I've run out of space in my inventory. Like, if you see this, I can't actually save any more screenshots. So at one point, I think I deleted the screenshot of this review, and yeah, basically I forgot what this review says. So I think we all missed out on some quality content. Oh yeah, and for hello, I actually put that rage review on a t-shirt. I'm such a meme lord. Okay, so let me show you a little funny thing I did. I recorded when this happened. I might do it in a separate review, but basically my noob-ass friend just got completely trolled by me. He was making a shit level, and I put some DLC in it, which was an accident. It was 100% of an accident. I didn't know he didn't have the history kit. But anyway, he got me to copy it so I could remove the DLC, since we were locked out of the level. And then I just stole his level. I mean, I was going to give it back to him, but then he realized by at that point that it was a crap level, so, yeah, you know. I think I deleted this level now, but basically, I actually made a real giveaway level. And at this point, everyone was skeptical of giveaway levels because, you know, 90% of them are fake. But I actually gave people the real costume, and like it was behind a real wait timer, and you can actually get the costumes from my level, and these are real. Like I got them through this same glitch. If I can actually find where I put them, super rare hacks. No, that's not it. Hacked rares. There it is. Yeah, I actually got these hacked t-shirts, and I don't have this DLC. I don't know if the glitch still works. They've probably patched it by now. Don't even know why they bother patching LittleBigPlanet 3, but yeah. I put the hacked rares in the game, and no one believed me because I put a timer on it, and actually made a secret walkway out of invisible material, because, you know, if you're going to be waiting for that long, you could probably figure it out by just clipping onto this invisible material. okay, let's just play the level, because this is what it looks like in play. I put in the Peace Day and Slurpee shirts, so you'd at least get something from attempting the level. And, you know, as a bargaining chip to say, yeah, I'm legit, I actually have the glitches. And when you hit the invisible wall here, not this time. Because basically, in LittleBigPlanet 1, I made this one level where it was like a locked key thing and you need a sticker to destroy the dissolve wall. And basically in LittleBigPlanet 3, because it was on the ground, you could actually go to the layer 4 and just go around the wall. So, yeah, with hindsight, I should have at least made it a bit higher up so people can go around it. Now, this invisible bridge, it's hard even for me. Like, I can't even find exactly where I have to go. I have to go in from memory. Yeah. Let's see. Yeah, it's just some, like, it's got to a point where I make entire levels just to make costumes or new stickers. Let's see. Yeah, I already did them. Picture room, hangout RPG. Oh yeah, this was another one of my deleted levels because I had to delete these levels in order to make more. Like, it's so annoying that there's a level limit. I mean, obviously there's obviously there's gonna be spam, but yeah. Can you please give me some kind of recording timer? PlayStation, if you're watching this, which I seriously doubt you are, please give me a recording timer for the thing, the share recordings, because that would be really helpful. Like, I know it's 15 minutes, and yeah, I could probably like get a stopwatch on my iPod, but you know, it wouldn't be 100%. And it's just easier if there was an on-screen timer so I could look at it and be like, yeah, I need to get ready for the next part. Yeah, I'm just doing some random pictures of LittleBigPlanet characters. And then, okay, let me just check if my settings off. Quick photo booth. Okay, good. Okay, so basically, this is also what I used in the SpongeBob level, except as soon as you enter the level, it activates. But basically, I made an emitter with photo booths on, and oh yeah, by the way, epilepsy warning. If you've got photosensitive epilepsy, this will vaporize your eyeballs. So just leave the video now if you've got photosensitive epilepsy. Don't say I didn't warn you. So yeah, I feel bad. Yeah, I know. I'm such a troll. I'm such an edgelord. uh, Okay, where are my other levels at? SpongeBob DLC 3. Oh yeah, this is pretty basic. There's just like one note, a troll face, and the sticker thing, and also some shit music. Don't steal or you'll be punished, kids. And when you end it. Oh yeah, there's a troll face. Yeah. It's sad because I don't think anyone will have found that. Same thing with my crown level, which I'll show in a bit. A lot of the funny parts of the level, people will have missed because of the, like, first part. What are these? I think this was another one of my troll levels.
Get wrecked, scrub. You thought you were gonna get the LittleBigPlanet Vita t-shirt, but you didn't, because you didn't pre-order the game, or found the glitch yourself, like lol. You should have got it, noobs.
Oh god, I actually recorded that, what was I thinking? Oh yeah, did I actually put in an invisible character thing here? I think I did, somewhere in the level. And it might have been like at the very back layer, but I think I did put the invisible character changer in. And yeah. So it's not like this level is a lie or anything. Where did I put it? It might have been at the very edge of the level, because I'm a dick like that. Oh yeah, that's because I don't use sensors. I actually use sticker panel with a collision detector, because you can actually make the exact shape you want instead of just a radius around the player sensor. Okay, at this point I'm pretty sure I didn't put in the character changer, unless it is at the edge of the level. Oh yeah, it is. Oh god, I'm such a dick. Your persistence has paid off. Yeah, indeed. I wonder if anyone's found it. Like, if any of you played the level at the time, I'd be interested to know if you actually found it. And there's the secret pink power. This wasn't a troll level, really. I basically pretended that this was a removed skin. And then I was hyping it up, and then, oh wait, it's just a sticker that looks kind of cool. But yeah. Hello friends, I have found a secret costume skin from Hacker DLC. This skin can only get stolen by whoever hacked it or stalks, but I cheated a way to get at it again. This is it, this is the end of all of it. I have conjured up a costume from the very bowels of the Media Molecule Torture Dungeon. This is the secret the Illuminati has been hiding with memes of dankest proportions. Do you have belief? This is real. Hail Satan 666. Okay, the ritual is complete. I will show you that. By the power vested in me by Anonymous, Lulsec, MLG, and Gamergate, I present to you the pink powder skin. I don't know why I put that animation. But yeah, it's like, you may or may not, but probably asking how to obtain the hacks. Good thing. I love how I just derped out in this lower. Well, tough chipolatas. I'm not telling the likes of you! I'm Source. We've come all the way to find the secret of the meaty skin flesh hack sword. So, here it is. The cheater code. Use it wisely. And then, yes. Yeah. No way, this one doesn't have the animation. Lol. You thought I hacked, but it's really just stickers. Have a productive day, and remember, winners don't do drugs and such. So yeah, that was that level. It wasn't even a troll, it was just like, lol, you thought you got a secret skin, but it's really just stickers. But in the end of the day, you know, does it matter? I mean, yeah, it's not an actual skin, but it still looks pretty freaking cool. Oh yeah, I made, okay, yeah, I don't know if I made this before or after the video. You may have remembered my Scum of LittleBigPlanet video, but yeah, I made this level, and I actually published it at the time, but I deleted it for space. I'm not actually this bad at making levels. I made the awkward camera and all this shit on purpose. I think I did make this in the review. But yeah. Oh yeah, by the way, I know the music sounds shit, and I'm not even that good at making music anyway. That's like, I avoid it on purpose. let's see. Oh yeah, a lot of these levels are just, you know, random crap I've made over the years. Okay, so let's see. Oh yeah, the Trigglypuff costume, Okay, has anyone heard of the Trigglypuff meme? Basically, there was this feminist who spazzed out at a conference with Milo Yiannopoulos, and because lol, I made a costume. Yeah, enjoy the memes. Yeah, and you can capture the costume. I think I captured her likeness perfectly, to be honest. Oh yeah, and also I found a glitch where if you have a custom character with a speech bubble, and then you go into it, and then you switch back, it'll actually keep the speech bubble. So yeah, that was fun. Secrets. Too many secrets. Oh, leaks. A lot of these aren't going to get finished, by the way. You will never see these levels. What even are these? I need to figure these out. It's a shame. Just look at all these unfinished levels. God damn it. Why? Oh, wait a second. Yeah, here's the troll level. Okay. This is probably the funniest thing I've ever done. I wish I was live streaming it now. Like, on the day when I was actually making the level with Reese, we just published it, and it instantly got like 100 plays at once, and it was legendary. It was lit. It was hilarious. But yeah, it got moderated, and I have a few theories as to why. It doesn't really make sense, because I'm not actually giving out the DLC. Basically, how the level would go... Oh yeah, funny story. Okay, this level looks a bit different because I've completed it and it saved the progress, because I included collectibles. But basically, you'd have to find these 10 collectibles across the level, and then you get access to the scoreboard. Yeah, I just troll people with the fake race gate. But yeah. I activated the scoreboard, but yeah, these are the costumes you get. Notice that the crown is actually fake, it's just the decoration crown. And there's all these. I don't know if I actually gave people these. Oh yeah, and then I made this invisible stream of collectibles, so you get one, then minus one, and then yeah. And if you actually got the jumps right, you could collect more collectibles out of it. And then there was one hidden behind here. There was also one behind the scoreboard and one at the round materials. Oh yeah, I didn't really show off the round materials. Funny story behind that was that either me or Reese came up with the idea to make these big blocks and then just either zoom in or zoom out with the UV tool, and it would make it look like they were unique rare materials, but they're actually existing materials. Like, I think this red one and this green one and flew on, I think they were all VR grid, really zoomed in, like on the grid lines. I think this was the acid material, and then, I can't remember what all these are, but I think this was the flowing neon material, zoomed out. I think these were gold materials. Don't remember what this one was. Yeah, like that was a pretty clever troll. This video is going to be like an hour long. I just realised. It wasn't intended to be, it was meant to just be some shits and giggles, but. You know, I have to add these levels to context. Okay, so. This is the part that just confused everyone. Like in all the reviews, people were raging, like, how do you do the jump? How do you do the jump? Because even if you corner jump it, it's too far. Because I actually made it so that the jump is too big and you can't get across no matter how hard you try. But, if you know the secret, you can just, like, jump up and grab an invisible material and then you can swing across. I know. And then there was, like, a collectible over there. And people were raging, they were absolutely fuming, they were like, how do I do this? How do I do the jump? Oh yeah, and here's a little homage to LittleBigPlanet 1, just for Telol. Oh yeah, I've collected half of these, but basically there's a rainbow made of collectibles that don't give you any score, in case anyone that you'd get the collectibles out of that. And also, yeah, there's a crazy sticker. I don't know if I actually gave the collectible for going there. But yeah, that was another little Easter egg. And then there'd be like a pile of gold collectibles and then one of them would be worth one collectible. Oh yeah. I think this also made people rage, like, a hell of a lot. Basically, it looks like there'd be a timer, but you can just, you know, pull the old switcheroo, this old trick, you can just go back through here and you can skip it. Or, you could even use the skateboard to jump over. Like, it was obviously fake. Like, obviously I wouldn't put a timer in any of my levels, like, when have I ever done that before? And it would just give you the price box. And it would deactivate the dissolve because, you know, I don't want to like lie to people or anything. And then I put in a TARDIS. I actually made this. And there'd be a collectible behind here. I think it actually looks cool. I couldn't get the effects right. I'm terrible at effects, by the way. I don't know why it like kind of flashes in and stuff. It's meant to just fade in and out. Yeah. Oh yeah, and there was a secret vehicle in the level. I wonder if anyone can guess what it is. Basically, yeah, it's the rocket cart from LittleBigPlanet 1. Okay, it's not 100% invisible. Like you might see the outline of it. But, that's because I put it to 1% opacity. No, because it wouldn't be fair if it was 100% invisible. But yeah, I put in the rocket cart, and the whole point of that was so that you could get to the secret scoreboard at the end. That would be like a secret podium. But, I can't be asked to go to it because... I've screwed up the rocket cart, and it's just going to push me into the corner. Whatever trolls did or two. Where did I put it? Put it somewhere around here. Somewhere. Oh yeah, Real Crown Code, no timer. This was more of my... This was one of my more straight-up trolls where I say, look, it's not worth it. Don't... Just don't... try and cheat the crown. And basically, I edited the first text because I linked it in after the last level I played, because I wanted to keep the level, but I didn't want to have like two fake crown levels, so that's why I made this a sub level. Yeah, I didn't want people to say it was fake in the reviews, because it is a bit of a social experiment. I want to see what people do. I think this is the crown sticker I made. Oh yeah, and if you keep going, here's the crown pin, and then keep going. Okay, I have to go with going, making it up. And I don't know if there was any more. And I think that is it. Unless there's anything else I missed, which there probably is. Well, yeah, so as you can see, this was an interesting look at the LittleBigPlanet community and how they act towards trolls like me. Yes. God, those reviews were just so autistic. Like, oh yeah, I know I'm autistic, and you say, oh, you shouldn't be offensive to the autistic because that's ableist, but, you know, I just don't take offense when people say, oh, you're so autistic, because, you know, if people are using it as an insult, then that says more about them than it does the people they're talking about. And if people use it as a joke, I laugh at the joke, because you can either be offended at everything or have a fun time. I choose to have a fun time. Anyway, where was I? Oh yeah. So yeah, these reviews are like totally autistic, and like, I'm not even joking, like, seriously, I think, like, you know, some of them may have autism, judging from the way they reacted. Like, I know when I see it. Anyway. Yeah, these were just shows you the kind of people that the LittleBigPlanet community is full of these days. And this game is, well, it was ruined years ago, but to be honest, I think I'm going to retire from the LittleBigPlanet community, because not only is the game just completely terrible now with all the glitches and the noobs, but also I don't actually have any space to save anything else. Like, I can't make any more costumes, and yes, I am aware that 90% of them are just variations of mine, but, you know, what can I say? I am addicted to making costumes. I do have some original costumes that aren't just variations of my own. I've made some for my now cancelled Ratchet and Clank level. It's a shame. I really wanted to make them all. I got some OCs here. Just have them all over there. Got all my obligatory saved glitches. Have my Fallout costumes from the level that fucking retard reviewed. To be honest, I think these are pretty good, but of course they are very limited because it's LittleBigPlanet and not Dreams. Oh yeah, I can't wait for Dreams, because I'll actually be able to make some really sweet ass stuff in Dreams. Like, I'll actually be able to make whatever I want without all the constraints of LittleBigPlanet. And I've got some big plans for Dreams. And hopefully I'll actually be able to make what I want to make, because in LittleBigPlanet, I've started something and then I'll be like, yeah, I'll finish it later, and I'll just procrastinate because I can't be asked to go back into the levels. So yeah. Oh yeah. These are some of the costumes my cousins made when they come around mine for family visits and all that. And also I made some Doctor Who costumes, which I never actually released. also some Adventure Time costumes to go with the DLC, and that's it. So yeah. I said to conclude. Yeah, thanks, PlayStation Share. Are you done cutting me off yet? I'll take that as a no. You aren't done cutting me off that. Yeah, thanks, PlayStation. I don't know why you're doing this. It's probably a glitch or some shit like that. But just sort out your shit, please. Just, yeah. As I was saying, to conclude. Okay, it didn't cut me off that time. Yeah, it's a nice behind-the-scenes look at some of my levels and some of the nice people that play them. You know, I've got some really good fans. And I've also got some actually good fans. Yeah, I was just being sarcastic. Fucking phone! Ah! Everything in this world is trying to cut me off. Okay, BRB. Okay. If I am allowed to finish my video, then let's finish it. So, as I was saying in the last, just the last minute of my video, which everyone in the world was trying to cut off, including Sony with these stupid glitches, I don't even remember what I was saying. It's been longer than it looks. Like, I've had to take a phone call, I've had to figure out what was going on with the PS4 share. But yeah. So yeah, these are just nice people that play my levels, and I was being sarcastic, but there are also some actually really good people. Some really good friends in the community. And I mean, some of them are actually my friends. Like, there are people who play my levels and say, lol, this is just a fake, like, but I'll review it and say it's real for the trolls. But then there's also my friends like Pan and Mad Martyrox who will play it and say, and do the same thing. But yeah, there are some decent people in the community, and it may look like, since I've cherry-picked just the worst, it looks like 90% of this community is autistic, including me, by the way. But no, it has got some decent people, and maybe I'll do a video showcasing that. I don't know. I've lost all the will to live after all those fucking reviews. Anyway, with that all said and done, and with no one trying to frickin' interrupt me now, goodbye. This was way longer than it should have been.